Another example is germanium. Germanium has very good optical and electrical material characteristics, which makes this material suitable for a wide variety of applications in the semiconductor world. The optical window for germanium is ideal for infrared applications at a broad range of wavelengths, which makes it ideal for use in lasers and novel imaging applications. One of those emerging applications is depth sensing used for face recognition, LiDAR, and augmented reality. Today, mainly VCSELs are used as active infrared light source for depth sensing. To increase the world-facing 3D sensing range, larger and more powerful VCSELs need to be developed. For face recognition in mobile phones, short wave infrared wavelengths make it possible to put a 3D sensing module behind the OLED displays, because the display is transparent for these wavelengths. Currently, VCSEL technology is using gallium arsenide as a substrate. However, due to the growing VCSEL array size, the only cost-effective way to produce these larger VCSELs will be on larger 8-inch wafer size, which is very difficult to do on gallium arsenide substrates. Germanium bulk wafers can be manufactured on 8-inch, dislocation-free and with very low bow, allowing improved yields and performance characteristics that exceed those of the current substrates. Therefore, germanium is the ideal material to enable a growing VCSEL market. Despite germanium's starring role in the transistor's early history, it was soon replaced by silicon to facilitate CMOS integration. At the 45-nanometer logic node, silicon germanium was introduced in the PFET source drain area to boost the performance. But now, remarkably, the material is poised for a comeback. The world's leading etch chipmakers are contemplating a change to the component at the very heart of the transistor, the current carrying channel. The idea is to replace the silicon there with a material that can move current at greater rates, and as such, make faster and energy-efficient circuits. Germanium tetrachloride is being used as a precursor to make germane, enabling epitaxial growth of silicon germanium source drain and channel areas. Imagine what could be done if a 12-inch germanium wafer could be integrated as a thin film in the future chip stacks. Also for germanium, Umicore is focused on sustainability and closing the loop. We use low-carbon primary germanium feed from zinc refining residues, which have an 85% lower carbon footprint compared to traditional coal-based sources. Recycled germanium further reduces the carbon dioxide footprint with more than another 50%. Umicore is globally recognized as a sustainable provider of germanium solutions. Today, over 50% of Umicore's germanium needs are sourced through recycling. Umicore envisions to source 100% from sustainable sources, being recycling of industrial scraps and low carbon footprint primary feed. Umicore has developed a germanium waste recycling technology, which can recover up to 95% of the germanium waste. This technology, based on specialized ion exchange techniques, is now already used in the optical fiber industry and is being evaluated for use in the semiconductor industry. Especially in chemical vapor deposition processes, 90% of the precursor goes directly to the exhaust. The cost of recycled germanium is on average 1/3 the cost of refining virgin germanium. Optical fiber manufacturers that have a good balance between their virgin and recycled material are able to reduce their raw material cost for germanium tetrachloride with about 40%. This is certainly worth considering for the germanium supply in the semiconductor industry.